Every single person sitting down have a testimony today.
Yeah.
I say you will have a testimony today. The Lord sent me with a prophetic word. Actually, 4 days ago. Wednesday, this is what you are going to speak about. And my text is from John 11 and verse 35. John 11 and verse 35. Shall we read together on the screen, on our feet? 1, 2, 3, go. Shall we all be on our feet? And let's read it together aloud.
Jesus wept.
Who wept?
Jesus.
Who wept?
Jesus.
Wept. Jesus wept. I'm speaking on a subject. Your weeping is over. If you want to say amen, say it better than your neighbor. You can say it louder, clearer, louder, better. Your weeping is over if you can say amen. Your family weeping is over in the name of Jesus. Your marital weeping in the name of Jesus is over. No more weeping in your life. No more weeping in your family.
Life, there must still be something that will make you to weep. The rich weep and the poor also weep. Man weep, woman weep. Don't tell her that they have been crying for years. Crying is inevitable. But it is a tragedy, or it is a dangerous thing for you to continue weeping. Because your weeping in life have a moment. Your weeping in life have a season. God does not protect you that you must be crying every day. No. In Psalm 30 and verse 5, he said his anger is but for a moment. In the strength of his life, weeping may endure but for a night. And joy come in the morning. Any situation that make you to continue weeping, then Satan is involved. May I say this to you? Not in 7 days. Whatever that is making your family to shed tears, it shall never happen again.